A number of tech firms are working on the future of chatbots, an AI platform trained to engage in conversation, and one in particular has gone viral.
Practitioners are surprised by how quickly these modern systems are developing, and some of them are starting to think we may have systems as smart as humans in as little as 10 years.
ChatGPT could wipe out his job too.
Literally my line of work, you know, apps, design work, product design work.
Well, 7 years ago, Sam Altman, Elon Musk, and others pooled more than $1 billion to research AI that benefits humanity. And then 3 years ago, Microsoft threw in another billion.
Talking about AI, I realized like, oh, well, this is a genie that once it's out of the bottle, you're never getting it back in.
That's true.
So for as long as I can remember, AI was always just around the corner. The future was supposed to have all these robots that took over all the menial tasks, replaced all manual labor, and allowed us to sit back and do the important knowledge work that only humans could do. But in reality, it seems that artificial intelligence is better at replacing our knowledge work than our physical labor. OpenAI is a company that created Dall-E, an AI image generator. Just type in any prompt and it will create it. And more recently, OpenAI released ChatGPT, an AI chatbot. Here's what Elon Musk said after a few days of using it. ChatGPT is scary good. We are not far from dangerously strong AI. So what can it do? Well, this is where it gets a little bit weird. You can ask it any question and it will explain it. You can ask it to explain it to you like you were 5 years old, to break it down simply. You can ask it to explain it to you using a certain style of speaking, like a surfer or a cowboy in an old Western. You can have it write essays, legal contracts, sales emails, song lyrics. You can have it translate languages. You can ask it to summarize books or videos or podcasts into bullet points. It can write a cover letter and a resume for you in 30 seconds flat. It can create song and lyrics in any musical style, or it can imitate any artist you want to name. It can help you debug code, and it could also just write code for you. By typing in a prompt, it can help you create simple scripts that you can use to create plugins, apps, and automate the things you do on the web. All this without you needing any technical knowledge to do it. I asked ChatGPT to write a 1,000-word script for a documentary about the power of ChatGPT, with some specific bullet points I wanted to mention, and it produced it flawlessly, including having parts for the narrator, a voiceover, as well as some people that are being interviewed about how they use ChatGPT. Now, we had software that could follow your commands or some prompts for a long time. Google Assistant, Alexa, as well as some new home devices. However, for the most part, those were pre-written commands. If you ask Google for the weather, it triggers a function that was written by a human being that handles that request. This new breed of AI is a little bit different. It draws on its knowledge to answer questions. The answers are its own, in the sense that the people who designed it don't necessarily even know what it's going to say. When you sign up, they warn you a number of times, we don't know what this thing is going to say, don't blame us. It learns from the massive amounts of data on the internet, and with time and feedback, it gets better and better. Whatever it can do now, it's just the starting point in its exponential learning curve. And people are noticing fast. Netflix took 41 months to reach 1 million users. Facebook, it took 10 months. For Instagram to reach a million users, it took 2.5 months. ChatGPT reached a million users in 5 days. That's a record. There's a massive amount of people using it every day, and the number is growing rapidly. The reason this is important is because the AI learns through human reinforcement. Each time somebody asks it a question or prompts it somehow, the AI is rewarded for giving satisfactory answers. Over time, and with millions and millions of people asking millions and millions of questions, this AI keeps getting better and better. Here's some ways in which ChatGPT will completely change the world. Some of these applications are already live and some are being rapidly developed. Keep in mind that this software has been only available to the public for a bit over a month at this point. One is legal work and negotiations. Already, people are using ChatGPT to create legal forms, contracts, terms of service for their websites. People have used it successfully to negotiate getting out of parking tickets, lowering their cable bills, and sending scary-sounding legal emails. A company called Do Not Pay is already using this tech to help people cancel subscriptions, reverse fees, and also help people sue companies that engage in predatory practices. 2. Education and mentoring. Education will be completely flipped upside down with this. First, you can write any paper, essay, whatever. You can get answers to your homework assignments in seconds. This AI has been tested on its ability to pass certain advanced exams in various fields, and it's capable of passing more of them than it should be able to. On the flip side, it provides incredible tutoring potential, especially for kids and students that either have special learning needs or simply don't have the resources to go to school. ChatGPT can create coursework, lectures for the students to read, and then answer any questions they have or explain any hard-to-grasp concepts. It will go at whatever speed the student needs to learn at. You won't get bored if it goes too slow, and it will slow down and keep explaining a subject for you for whatever amount of time you want it to. Right now it's free, but it will likely have some fee later in the future, but the cost to provide this AI to, let's say, a learning institution will be negligible. Any kid with a laptop and internet connection anywhere in the world can have a world-class tutor helping them. Again, keep in mind, this is out of the box, so to speak. Let people train this AI for this specific task for a few years and it's going to be infinitely better. Already we have technology that can create speech from text. We also have video that is generated with AI. So if it's better for students to see a human likeness teaching them, we have that technology. 3 is business. This is where it gets really interesting, but also kind of scary because of the sheer amount of people and businesses that it will make obsolete. Chatbots can interact with your customers one-on-one, helping them to select the right product, answering their questions, and pushing them to complete the sale on your web store. They can follow up with them to make sure they receive the package and ask for reviews. They can write all the content for emails and social media, all the product descriptions, etc. AI automation consultants will be a very in-demand industry for e-commerce owners. 4, coding. Right now, the AI can spit out real working code with just a prompt. Now, it's not the same as coding up complex software all on its own, but this gives the ability for anyone regardless of tech background to start coding simple scripts. This AI can also help explain exactly what each piece of code does and what steps you would need to take to make that into a Chrome plugin, for example. This allows millions of people to start coding, start learning for free in their spare time. They're able to do it without attending college, without paying for classes, or having to schedule meetings with tutors. Do you hate getting those email opt-ins and pop-ups on websites? You can take 5 minutes right now and create a plugin that will eliminate them. You will have learned a new skill and also stopped a lot of frustration. This alone can take our coding literacy from only a few percentage of people to a large portion of the population. 5, any creative medium. We tend to think of people who create art and graphics and movies as being the creatives. They are the people with the natural talent for being creative, having a vision, etc. A different way of thinking about this is that they are adept at using whatever medium they produce their art in. A person who paints beautifully spent a lot of time and effort to learn how to do that. A movie director spent a lot of time working with cameras, movie sets, etc. But what percent of that is creativity versus just technical ability? If everyone had the same exceptional technical ability to create images and graphic design, anything they could explain well enough to a computer, that would allow anyone to create whatever art or visual medium that they want to, regardless of skill. ChatGPT is also a potential death threat to Google. Here's an excerpt from the New York Times. Although ChatGPT still has plenty of room for improvement, its release led to Google's management to declare a code red. For Google, this was akin to pulling the fire alarm. Some fear that the company may be approaching a moment that the biggest Silicon Valley outfits dread: the arrival of an enormous technological change that could upend the business. For more than 20 years, the Google search engine has served as the world's primary gateway to the internet. But with a new kind of chatbot, technology poised to reinvent, or even replace traditional search engines, Google could face the first serious threat to its main search engine business. One Google executive described the effort as make or break for Google's future. And I gotta say, I kind of agree. I asked ChatGPT to calculate my daily calorie needs to lose weight. I gave it my age, height, etc. It did that calculation while explaining very simply how that calculation was made, what the rationale behind it was. Then I asked for a meal plan based on these calories, as well as a shopping list and some recipes. It did all of that in seconds, with no ads, no pop-ups. I didn't have to read some fluffed up article about fitness and losing weight and whatnot. It was just the info that I needed and nothing else. And it was specific to me, it was customized to me. As I was making notes for this video, I found myself, and this happened repeatedly, I would open a new Google search tab, stop myself, and then go to ChatGPT and ask it the questions I had intended to search. Each time, I would say ChatGPT served a much better experience than Google did. Out of the box, this experience is infinitely better. Now, it's important to understand that a lot of these use cases that I'm talking about will be minor compared to how this technology will fundamentally change our society. As you may know, we recently had a breakthrough in fusion energy, which could mean cheap, abundant, safe energy. Now, energy and computational power are the potential limiting factors for the growth of AI. If we have AI, energy, and supercomputers, there are a lot of solutions that can be had if we just point it at the right problem. For example, with genomics and genetic engineering. We know it's theoretically possible to fix a lot of the health issues we have by modifying our genetic code. We can also design bacteria that can eat stuff that we don't like waste plastics. And we can make it produce things that we need, like biofuels. Genomic companies like Illumina are already using AI to have breakthroughs in the field. The potential is so big that the founder of OpenAI refuses to make any long-term predictions because he says it's impossible to predict the exponential growth we are about to experience. But he is saying that you should be paying attention. Here's his recommendation.
And so if someone, kind of going back now to the one of the first questions I asked, if you're a student or a founder today, if you could just, if you were to point them in a single direction for how to prepare for this world, would you say go work for a company like OpenAI? Would it be just start doing some AI research or just start building
anything in the field, like start building, come to OpenAI, whatever, you just like get, like don't miss out on this one. Like just get up to speed now would be my advice, however you do it.
Yep, makes total sense.
If this stuff interests you, click subscribe. I think we're about to see some incredible change occurring in a very short time period. I plan to be building businesses and solutions in this field and contributing in whatever way I can. But whether you choose to dive in or you just want to stay informed and not get left behind, stick with me. The biggest mistakes I've made in the past with regards to business and investing was to not go all in on a new tech that I knew in my gut was going to be big. And I'm not gonna make that mistake again. And this feels like the biggest thing there ever was, potentially. My name is Wes Roth. Thank you for watching.